Okay, and I'm back with another lesson. Imperativo dos, empezar.
Завтра сделаю все, как хочешь.
Mañana. Oh, Duolingo's actually giving me the rest of this. ¿Cómo quieres? This one, this is ¿cómo quieres? Mañana, haz todo como quieras. Mañana, oops, switch my keyboard. Haz todo como quieras. In English, this means tomorrow, do everything you want. I believe. Quieras. No. Start over.
А теперь объясни это маме.
Yeah.
Объясни.
Hello.
Это маме. А теперь объясни. Это. Это.
I don't know why they're giving me that. Ahora, explícala. Doesn't esto, not sure about the sentence actually. Y ahora explíquela esto a mamá. No.
Это объясни.
Try that.
Это маме.
Now explain it to mom. Speak like Esther. I'm not quite sure why Esther is there. Let me just check this. Now explain this to mom. I'm actually confused as to why there's L and Esther at the same time. Okay. Try again.
Можете повторить?
Можете, puede.
Можете повторить?
Could you repeat, probably in English, is the polite way.
Дети, играйте вместе.
Дети, is niños, niños, играйте.
Играйте.
Jueguen. Вместе, juntos.
Вместе. Дети, играйте вместе.
Дети, играйте вместе. Niños, jueguen juntos. That would just be children play together.
Что ты сказал? Повтори, пожалуйста.
Что ты сказал? Okay. Has dicho. Oops, sorry. Okay. Has dicho. that. Duolingo doesn't care about punctuation, but I like to throw it in because it's good practice. ¿Qué has dicho?
Что ты сказал? Повтори, пожалуйста.
Hi, kitty. And I guess my cat wants to be on the stream. This is very awkward. I can't do a Duolingo lesson this way, cat.
Иди играй с этим мальчиком.
Иди играй. Oh. I think иди means go. Right?
Иди.
In English, from Russian to English, it would mean go.
Иди.
Да? In Spanish, играй.
Играй.
Again, yeah.
Играй.
С. Con, or with in English.
Этим.
Этим is
этим.
A declined form of это. So, they juega con este.
Мальчиком.
Nino. Actually, yes, that makes sense in Spanish. Go and play with this boy.
Что ты сказал? Повтори, пожалуйста.
Что ты сказал? Повтори, пожалуйста. Что ты сказал? Повтори, пожалуйста. I actually got the idle right. See, most of the time I skip it because I don't want my microphone to go weird and then I lose out. They really only give you one chance to get it right. And then you lose point. And then you lose your perfect streak. You know, some people have complained about the Duolingo duo popping up and giving you, you know, little encouraging messages here. I actually really like Duo. I just wish they wouldn't use Duo as the messenger for their news and updates, which is sometimes just stuff we don't want them to change. But whatever. Continue.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
Сделайте это задание.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
Okay. Probably words I've learned, because it doesn't look... Let's see. Then это...
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
This is kind of painful because they're not giving me the audio for each one.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
La el próximo miércoles. El próximo miércoles.
Пожалуйста, объясни мне, как это делать. Пожалуйста, объясни мне, как это делать.
Okay, меня is a declined form in Russian. For the first person singular pronoun, so it would be me.
Пожалуйста, объясни мне, как это делать.
Объясни мне. Okay. Explica-me. Как is like how. Explica-me como. Я сяло. Кому? Афе. Но. Кому?
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде. Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
Сделайте.
Сделайте это задание.
К следующей среде.
Следующая среда.
Среде.
Среда.
Среде.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде. Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
Сделайте это задание. I didn't finish talking and they decided to tell me I'm wrong. See, no, that's an example of why I don't like their audio. They only give you one chance and you're wrong, you lose your perfect thing. So I'm going to actually restart because I want to get perfect. And that sentence was awfully painful to try and pronounce in Russian. So actually, I will probably skip that one next time because I need more practice on that. Without Duolingo telling me, oh my god, you're wrong.
Пожалуйста, повторите последнее слово.
Okay, four.
Повторите. Последнее слово.
La. Por favor, repita la última palabra. Пожалуйста.
Пожалуйста, повторите последнее слово.
Повторите последнее слово. So in English this means please repeat the last word.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
And this one again. Это... Это...
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
Сделайте. See, this part is in the D. It's actually pretty hard for English speakers to pronounce. Сделайте. So I'm not entirely sure if you have the s sound, I think, which is actually an unvoiced consonant, and then you have a d, which is a voiced consonant. I think what's supposed to happen here when you try to pronounce this is you don't try to pronounce s and d together. I think the eleventh sister.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде. Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
Happening, and what I hear from her is that the s is actually morphing to z because of the voiced d consonant here. So s is unvoiced, d is voiced, z is voiced, and so this would morph to z to match the voicing, and it makes it easier to pronounce. So сделайте это задание.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
I'm trying to break down these into syllables.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
She says this like следующее. What does Duolingo say?
Следующий.
Okay, she says следующий.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
Следующий. Hey, let me highlight this, please. Oh.
Среде.
Среде. Okay. Moving on.
Дима, играй тихо. Мама спит.
Дима, играй тихо. Means quiet. Right? So the emphasis. Дима. Charlie said in English this is Дима, be quiet. Mama is sleeping. Sure about that.
Играй.
Play quiet.
Тихо. Yeah. Играй.
Play-ga.
Тихо.
Tranquilo. And use tranquilo. Play quietly. Mama.
Mama. Speed.
Está durmiendo. Okay, that is correct. I think. Oh, no. Play-ga and Smincio.
Тихо.
You know, they don't give you that here.
Тихо.
Today, huh?
Играй.
You
тихо.
See that? Hover over. If you're a beginner.
Тихо.
It does not help.
Мама. Спит.
Мама.
Мама.
Well, you could probably just say mom is sleeping. Mama está durmiendo is correct. It's just this part I think that is wrong. Let's just start that over. Wow, they're giving me actually harder ones than they did yesterday.
Объясни это задание еще раз.
Еще раз is again, de nuevo in Spanish.
Еще.
Okay, yes, literally it's one more time.
Раз.
I guess you could say.
Еще.
I don't know why they don't want me to say de nuevo.
Еще.
Because de nuevo in Spanish does mean again. Whatever.
Объясни.
Explica.
Задание.
Esta tarea.
Еще.
What's the best? Which one do you think is going to give it to us? Explica esta tarea.
Раз.
Una vez más is what they want.
Не садись на этот стул. Садись.
No te sientes. Esta silla. No sedis.
Садись.
No sedis. Не sedis.
Не садись на этот стул.
Не садись на этот стул. Stool is a chair, I believe. I'm being swarmed by a cat.
Стул.
Yeah.
Этот. На.
Okay, in English, this means... In English...
Не садись на этот стул.
Не садись на этот стул. Translated in Spanish is no te sientes en esta silla. In English is don't sit on this chair.
Садись, где хочешь.
Okay, so now we have to switch to my Russian keyboard. Let's see if the spelling right. What is that? I'm not sure. Let's try and check. Садись. Yes, I got that one right.
Садись, где хочешь.
Oops. Yeah.
Садись, где хочешь.
I think that's the right one. Yeah. Хочешь. Oh my god, they spelled the Russian words right, I think. Yes. Okay, so yes. And now they're giving us the Spanish translation. Siéntate donde quieras, it means in English, sit where you want.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде. Сделайте.
Oops. Back to my US International keyboard. Again. Esta tarea para el, now I remember this one, próximo miércoles.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде. Пожалуйста, повторите последнее слово.
Favor. Get used to saying this in Russian. Пожалуйста. Means por favor in Spanish. Okay, we learned this and I'm forgetting what it means. Let me... повторите.
Пожалуйста, повторите последнее слово.
So, this now. Repite la última palabra. Por favor, repite la última palabra. English means please repeat the last word. Repita. Oh, is it? Oh. It actually gave it to me.
Дети, играйте вместе.
Дети, minus, minus. Играйте вместе. Juegan juntos. Right?
Играйте.
Juegan juntos. Boys play together.
Пожалуйста, повторите последнее слово.
I could probably do this one, but I don't want to risk them telling me I'm wrong or cutting me off before I finish saying anything. Пожалуйста, повторите последнее слово. Последнее слово.
Пожалуйста, повторите последнее слово.
Should I risk it? No. Пожалуйста, повторите последнее слово. That one was easy for me for some reason. Пожалуйста, повторите последнее слово. That's not too hard for English speakers, actually. They won't have those weird consonant clusters that we kind of like stumble
over. Можете повторить.
Можете. Puede. Repetir.
Что ты сказал? Повтори, пожалуйста.
Что ты сказал? Сказал is the past tense here. Is the past tense of here for, I think the Russian infinitive is сказать. I could be wrong, but either way, it means to say. So there's a I learned скажите, пожалуйста. And in Russian that's kind of like saying, oh, say, please. That's how they might interrupt somebody to ask them for directions or something. Скажите, пожалуйста. I believe it is.
Сказал.
You'll notice that
сказал.
The changes the «ш» for some reason. Language morphing. Что ты сказал?
Что ты сказал?
Oh, yeah. Астичо.
Ты.
Си. Spanish.
Ты.
The second person, singular, informal. Повтори, пожалуйста.
Повтори.
Repite. Repite. Por favor. Why?
Можете повторить?
Можете повторить.
Можете повторить?
Можете повторить. Okay, that was a lot easier than that horrible one before. Okay.
Тебе нравится эта песня? Конечно.
Тебе нравится?
Нравится.
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 No, be careful not to say нравится. You have to say just the end. So нравится. Это?
Песня.
Песня. Is una canción. So that means song in English.
Тебе.
Тебе нравится. In English means you like. So the question form is like, do you like? This whole thing means, do you like this song in English? And конечно, I believe, means of course.
Конечно.
Yeah. So now let's try the Spanish.
Тебе. Нравится.
Let's see. My Spanish. Te gusta esta canción.
Песня.
¿Te gusta esta canción? Por supuesto. Of course.
Yes. Завтра сделай все, как хочешь.
Man, you went in this one pretty early. In the lesson, before I had to restart a few more times. Then, завтра сделай. Сделай все. Mañana haz todo
как?
Como quieras. Mañana haz todo como quieras. Okay. Yeah. So,
Хочешь.
Is the second person informal for to want? I believe the formal is хочете? So
хочешь.
Yeah, it ends in that sh sound. That Russian sh sound. So now you know that for when you go to Spanish,
хочешь.
You should be using the to form of the Spanish. Okay, you're right. Mañana haz todo como quieras. I think I got wrong last time because I put quieres.
Конечно, я это знаю.
Конечно, я это знаю. Yes, this would mean in English, of course, I know this. You're that. Конечно, я это знаю. Конечно, я это знаю. Это. Oh. So in Spanish, por supuesto, yo sé esto.
Иди играй с этим мальчиком.
Ve y juega.
Иди и играй.
With este niño.
Мальчиком, этим. Иди.
Ve y juega con este niño. Okay, there you go. Иди и играй с этим.
Иди и играй с этим мальчиком.
Иди и играй с этим.
Этим. Иди и играй с этим мальчиком.
Иди и играй. So all these three, e is in all of these three, so they kind of morph together. They slur together. Иди и играй.
Иди играй с этим мальчиком.
Иди играй с этим мальчиком. Мальчиком.
Мальчиком.
Мальчик is the nominative form of in Russian for boy. So we get niño in Spanish. This form, мальчиком, I believe, would be...
мальчиком.
Weird. Maybe it's the instrumental мальчиком. Form. It's in the instrumental case for мальчик. Yeah, that's right. Niños juegan juntos. Ah, we learned this. Дети играйте вместе.
Сначала сделай уроки, а потом играй.
I'm not going to try this one, actually.
Сначала сделай уроки, а потом играй.
Сначала сделай уроки, а потом играй. Let's try it out. I'm not sure what that means.
Сначала сделай уроки, а потом играй.
Yes, but I'm not going to try and pronounce that one because I'll probably mess it up and I'll have to do the lesson all over again. It will be here all day. So in Spanish, Spanish translation is primero haz las lecciones y luego juega. And so in English, this would be first do the lessons and play later. Which is actually what I'm going to do. First, I'm doing my Duolingo lessons and then I'm going to play. Y ahora explicarle esto a mamá. Y ahora es at the pier. So it's not this one, because y ahora es at the pier, at the pier. Explicarle being tricky, right? But we know esto means etta. Hagan esta tarea para, tarea is a Daniel. Yes, let us share the I want to hear this again because this one just is hard for me to pronounce.
Сделайте это задание к следующей среде. Сделайте это задание к следующей среде. Сделайте это задание к следующей среде. Сделайте это задание к следующей среде.
Now this sentence just does not come off the tongue very easily, does it? Not even in Russian, it doesn't sound like, I don't know. It sounds awkward. Anyway, that should be right. ¿Qué has dicho? Repite, por favor. Okay. Yo te escuchar. ¿Has dicho? Past tense. That's the Spanish past tense for said. Or, well, since it's a question form in English, would be, what did you say? So, the Russian is что ты сказал. And so, this is pronounced что. For a reason. You can't say ch, you can't say that ch with the t, right? And they, so they just kind of ch. Yeah, it's kind of really hard to pronounce, right? So the Russian word here is что. Что ты сказал? You want to say, maybe I have to move. Повтори. If it's that. Повтори, пожалуйста. And we are finally done. Yay! I'm pretty sure if I did that last speech exercise, I would have messed that one up and had to restart, and we'd be here a lot longer. Continue. And that's the last one. Exercise. And let's see if I remember my Spanish numbers today. I didn't really yesterday. Tienes una racha de 1900. Oh no. Nuevo. Días. I have a streak of 1909 days. Meto una lección todos los días para crear tu racha. Yes, well. Anyways, I do know that's maintained my streak. Continue. Lección completada. Yes, experiencia. I think it is. Experiencia. Experience. Yeah, see, now I remember. Yes, experiencias. And super bono. Cinco experiencia. Hoy ganaste. I remember 15. Oh, no, no. I don't remember. Quince. Oye, ganaste 15 experiencias? Quince. Let's try this. I want to put this in Spanish. Let's see if Google Translate's smart.
Quince XP.
Okay, that is actually funny. Quince, yes, I was right, but it is quince. Oye, ganaste 15 experiencias. Or, well, I guess it's experience points. So, puntos, quince puntos de experiencia, maybe is what you might say in Spanish. Let's try, would you say that? What would you say in Spanish? No, they're not. Okay, open Google Translate. English to Spanish. Puntos de experiencia. Okay. Yes. Voy a ganaste 15 puntos de experiencia. Ganaste dos lingos. Trabajaste duro y alcanzaste tu meta diaria. Yes. Trabajaste duro means hard in Spanish. That's a funny expression. It's like, trabajaste. Oh no, this is, you worked hard and achieved your daily goal. And that's what I would say it means. You worked hard and reached your daily goal. And there we go. We are done. My Russian for Spanish speakers course, lesson for today. And you see now it says 60% completada, 60% complete. I am doing this course fresh and new. So Russian or Spanish speakers course that I've been doing. I'm taking my time with it because, like I said, I really like Russian. I really like Spanish. Other courses I might try to push on and just fly through them and review them later. But I just kind of not minding taking my time with the Russian and Spanish here. So I'm on this one. There's four here. In Duolingo, I have this thing now that when you get to a certain stage after skills, you're going to have to do a test. And so that's about how much I have left for this course. And then I'll be done this one. I've already completed the Russian for English speakers course, just each skill going up to pretty much level one. But because I like Russian and Spanish, I wanted to do this one. And you can see Russian for English speakers. Well, actually, I have kind of made some progress on this one a bit more. To review the Russian, I kind of pushed some of them up to some of the skills up to level two. And English, the English version of this course has more tips than the Spanish one. Probably because Russian is pretty hard for English speakers. But like you can, as you can see, I did finish the course. I got my Duolingo, my golden owl. I miss the old golden owls with their pretty little scarves for each language. Bad choice. Everyone was really upset. They liked those. And as you can see, I used one as an avatar. So I guess I'll switch back to my cursor de Russo, my Russian course in Spanish. It's down here somewhere. Yes, there it is. Anyways, so that's my Duolingo lesson for today, and I've maintained my streak once more. Now I'm off to play something else, and sadly I would be playing Monster Hunter World, but it's the weekend and I have a new board game, Terraforming Mars, that I'm testing out before my boyfriend and I bring it to our gaming night. Anyways, that's it for today. See you next time.